And to tell us more about Baguio City's rehabilitation plans, we have on the line Baguio Mayor Benjamin Magalong. He met with the country's tourism and local government chiefs Friday to discuss the national government's role in its rehabilitation. Mayor Magalong, thank you so much for taking our call.
Good afternoon, Rain. Good afternoon to our listeners.
The reports say Baguio is beset with pests, aging, overpopulation, and a dwindling number of pine trees. How are we targeting these with the rehab efforts?
That is true, Rain. We have a lot of issues now with regards to our dwindling pine trees. In fact, for the past 20 years, we have significantly reduced the number of pine trees, adult pine trees, from 700 to only 418,000 now. So what we're planning to do is we're crafting our regreening program, a 10-year regreening program from 2020 to 2030. And it entails the planting of seedlings, as much as 40,000 seedlings per year.
Right. You're rehabilitating the sewerage system as well, major roads, putting up parking buildings, a cable car and monorail systems. Those are quite ambitious. That's a lot. What's the urgent priority?
That is true. In fact, we're the first local government unit that submitted its expression of interest on low-carbon urban transport system. The good news is we have a lot of proponents to participate in the public-private partnership. And so we have lined up these projects as a form of strategic solutions to address our problems on environment, problems on traffic congestion.
Right. How much are these rehabilitation efforts expected to contribute to the tourism revenues of Baguio? Where are you currently in terms of tourism revenues, and what's the target after the rehab efforts? And you're saying it will end by 2030.
Just to inform you, Rain, is that according to our Hotel and Restaurant Association of Baguio City, last December was one of the highest number of visitors recorded for the past several years. And with this impending rehabilitation, we're expecting that there will be a significant reduction in tourist arrivals. But probably after 3 years, then we can see an increasing trend again. One of the major areas that will be rehabilitated is the Burnham Park at a staggering amount of about 480 million pesos.
Right. So 480 million, that's going to be just for Burnham Park. What about all the other efforts? How much is that going to...
Yeah.
Contribute, and because of these rehabilitation efforts, you're not going to shut down the whole of Baguio, but it might actually affect your tourism numbers for the meantime. How much revenue loss are you expecting?
Right now, we cannot quantify the revenue loss, but there's no way we will be able to, there's no way we'll close down the city of Baguio. Besides, it's a gateway to the other Cordillera provinces, and second is we have 6 ingress and egress, and no way we will be able to monitor visitors who will be coming into the city of Baguio. Our sewerage system would probably entail around 22 billion pesos to totally rehabilitate it. Our water supply, it entails around 600 million pesos to be able to have a consistent water supply, to be able to address our shortage, especially during the summer season. As I've said, we don't have any, cannot quantify at the moment revenue loss in terms of reduction in tourist arrivals.
Right. What about the road works? And you mentioned some public-private partnership programs. Can you mention some of the contractors who are interested already and which projects? Plus, are we fashioning Baguio's rehabilitation after any particular world destination?
Yeah, at the moment, some big contractors are interested in putting up our terminals, integrated transport terminals, Megawide is now crafting its proposal for the South Terminal. SM Terminal Group is in the process of designing the North Terminal, Integrated Transport Terminal. And we have a group of a consortium of bus companies that are also signified their intention to put up the Integrated Transport Terminal at the west side of the city. Second is we have companies that are also interested in the parking buildings. Mm. And other companies are also interested in PPP projects for our sewage system. Mm-hmm. So a lot of companies are actually interested in, you know, for the fact that, they'll be able to generate profit from these projects. Just would like also to inform you that we're going to modernize our market, the amount of 6 billion pesos. And I've been talking to big companies now, like Pure Gold owner Lushuko, Jeff William of SM, other personalities such as Peter Na, has also signified his intention to have a joint venture on the market modernization.
Right. Have you spoken with locals, Mayor, who may be affected by the rehabilitation efforts? Have the violators of city zoning ordinances been informed? And what is the next course of action with regards to those violators? Have there been appeals to not touch certain heritage sites?
Yes, we have already sent out notices to violators of our comprehensive land use plan. And one particular sector will be the hotel owners. We're in around 26 hotel owners for the past several years were able to convert their parking into grocery stores. And we have already written them, notified them that we want them to revert to the usual, to the original plan that they should be parking buildings. And we're giving them 6 months to rehabilitate their basement. Second is we have also given notices to establishments, owners of structures that have occupied the road right of way. And in fact, we're doing the demolition of several structures that have occupied the sites of Marcos Highway. Second is Cannon Road, and next areas that we're going to demolish some structures would be Naguilian Road, Luacan Road, and the road going to La Trinidad. Third is we're also sending out notices to people who have occupied waterways. We're going to implement a three-meter easement. And around 2,000 families will be affected.
Right. Does that mean that they will have to be, resettled in another area of Baguio? And of course, one of the problems is overpopulation. You have 10 times more people than your capacity, actually. So that's 380 million versus the 30 million capacity. Is there a plan to target this overpopulation? Are they supposed to be decentralized from Baguio?
Okay, good question. Well, one is, I would like to inform you that the Baguio City is only designed for 30,000 people.
30,000?
Originally. Hmm. And now we have a population of about, in 2015, that was 345,000. Hmm. We did an extrapolation, and this year we have about 367,000. 10 years from now, we'll probably hit around 468,000 people in the city of Baguio. Hmm. Our daytime population is around 500,000 to 600,000. When the tourist arrives, we're up to 700,000 to 900,000. And our road capacity can only accommodate around 15,000 vehicles. In 2018, we have about 64,000 vehicles, registered vehicles in the city, 25,000 of which are motorcycles. So we have a huge, we have a huge problem with regards to a lot of people. basically the population and
Mayor, sorry, making sure that
10 years from now we'll be able to address the issues that so we have to make sure that at present we have to execute our strategic solution so that 10 years from now we won't experience what we're experiencing today.
Right. Of course, overpopulation means environmental damage as well. Now, if the goal is responsible and sustainable tourism, what have you already undertaken to this end, or what can you undertake to address that overpopulation and push for sustainable tourism?
Yeah, right. Right now, we're, as I've said, that we're coming up with our master plans to address, the environmental issues that we're facing. One is our contaminated rivers. Second is our solid waste management. Third is our liquid waste, our wastewater. So these are the things that we're looking at, and we were able to come up with our master plans, and we're just crafting our technical designs so that we'll be able to invite proponents to participate in the public-private partnership project.